What's up, guys? If you are a Battlefield 4 fan, be sure to check out my other video that went live today. You can have a chance to win a free Battlefield 4 Ultimate Utility app from Brass Monkey. Link in the description, annotation on the screen, and Lagan is back. It's Sunday, that means it's a top 5, and it's zombie related, but it's almost Halloween. So he wanted to do a top 5 zombie movies of all time. So you guys enjoy that, check out his channel, be sure to sub him up. And maybe he'll be back for some extinction mode when Call of Duty Ghost gets out here. I'll talk to you later.
It's your boy Lagan24 coming at you with the top 5 zombie movies of all time. What's up, everybody? Yeah, so let's just jump right into number 5. It's going to be Shaun of the Dead, the 2004 British zombie comedy, which is absolutely hilarious. Takes place in London. And Simon Pegg and Nick Frost are the main actors. And this movie centers around the main character, Shaun. He's trying to get some sort of grasp or focus on his otherwise shitty life, and he's trying to get his ex-girlfriend back, and he's got to deal with his mother and his a-hole of a stepfather, and all while dealing with an apocalyptic zombie outbreak. You know, just everyday stuff. You ever try to kill a zombie with a record player? Well, these guys did. It was really funny. There's so many one-liners from this movie. I laughed from start to finish. Brilliant film. Not usually a fan of British humor, but this one was just great, man. I get it. I wish they'd make a sequel. It's been 10 years now. No sequel so far. But maybe. We'll just cross our fingers. This thing only grossed $30 million worldwide, which is not very good. You'll hear some other numbers as this list goes on. You'll see why that's not so good. But when the DVD sales came out, this thing took off like a wildfire. For me, it's a classic. I love it. Let's move on to number 4. Coming in at number 4 is 28 Days Later. This is a 2002 English post-apocalyptic horror film, another English film. I guess the English know they're zombies. This one was really good. It starred Cillian Murphy, Naomi Harris, Megan Burns, just to name a few. There's a few more. And the plot is, it's basically a breakdown of society following the accidental release of a highly contagious virus and focuses upon the struggle of 4 survivors to cope with the destruction of life that they once knew. Now, some of the things I remember about this movie is the opening scene. Dude gets out of a hospital bed. The hospital's like empty. There's nobody in there. He wanders out to the street, and basically, I think it's downtown London. You'll have to excuse me, but it's just completely deserted. Little fires here and there and some destruction, but completely deserted. This movie reinvented the zombie as we all know it. They were fast. They were aggressive. They were extremely, extremely agitated. And it really was a scary movie filled with bunches of jump scares. And I loved it, man. This one was awesome. Now, surprisingly, this movie only had a budget of $5 million, but it grossed $82 million worldwide, which is pretty damn good profit, if you ask me. It's number 4 on the list for very good reason. There was also, I guess we can go 4.5. It would be 28 Weeks Later was the 2007 sequel that 28 Days Later spawned, and it was also pretty good. Not officially part of the list, but you could tag it along with this one if you want to. Let's move on to number 3. Coming in at number 3 is Zombieland. I love it. This thing is funny. This is an American zombie comedy, and it starred Woody Harrelson. Oh, this came out in 2009, by the way. Starring Woody Harrelson, Jesse Eisenberg, Emma Stone, and some other girl. And the movie basically is about this road trip that takes place across the United States trying to find a zombie-free zone where they're all going to be safe at. And the movie starts with Jesse Eisenberg's character, and he eventually meets Woody Harrelson's character, and then through their travels, they eventually meet Emma Stone and her character and the other girl. The other girl. I'm sorry, I don't know her name. The other girl. Fuck it. And they've got to learn to trust each other. There's tons of gore, lots of comedy, just some great, really cool killing scenes. And it's just a really funny movie. Now, with all of these zombie movies, it's kind of fun to figure out and see where the virus originated from. And in this case, it was a strain of mutated mad cow disease that mutated into mad person's disease, which became known as mad zombie disease, which overran the entire United States and turned all the American people into vicious zombies. Of course, you're safe if you don't eat meat, so that would explain some of the survivors, but really funny. And of course, Bill Murray makes a cameo in this that, if you've seen the movie, is absolutely priceless. So please, if you haven't watched this one, do yourself a favor, rent it this weekend, watch it with your girlfriend, watch it with your significant other, whoever. Watch it by yourself, it doesn't matter. It's hilarious. This one grossed over $102 million in the box office, so very successful, very funny movie. That was my number three. Let's move on to number two. And the number two on my list of top five zombie movies of all time is going to be Dawn of the Dead 2004 remake. Don't get it confused with the original, directed by George A. Romero. All of my Call of Duty zombie fans out there, you're going to know George Romero, aren't you, from Call of the Dead. He originally did Dawn of the Dead in 1978, but the 2004 version is much better. Trust me on that. Now, this one is awesome. Okay, you don't have to wait a split second for some action in this one. It starts out with the main character and her husband having sex in a shower. And because of this, they miss a TV bulletin, an emergency broadcast warning. They just hop in bed and go to sleep. Well, the next morning, there's a zombie in their bedroom, and he bites the living shit out of her husband's neck. There's a gaping wound. There's blood everywhere. She escapes outside to the neighborhood, only to see the entire neighborhood is in chaos. It's crazy. There's cars crashing into cars and explosions and zombies chasing down people and people running and screaming. And it's just, she escapes. She meets up with the other main characters, Ving Rhames, Jake Weber, Mekhi Phifer. They all escape to a mall in which they barricade themselves into the mall. There's other survivors in the mall. There's struggle against the survivors. There's some drama inside there. A couple of zombies get in from time to time that they've got to deal with. We get to see a zombie baby in this movie, which is crazy. And they go up on the roof, and on the roof of the mall where they're staying at, across the street is an ammo store. And there's the owner of the ammo store who's up on his roof. And they communicate back and forth using a giant whiteboard. And they erase their messages and write new messages. The reason I'm bringing this up, if you buy the DVD of this movie, the guy who owns the ammo store, you'll get like a miniature film of his side of the story. All the stuff that he's doing while we're actually watching the survivors in the mall. They give you like a 20 or 30 minute mini film of everything he had to endure. So it's a really cool DVD. I recommend you pick it up. This movie grossed, I think it was $102 million again at the box office, and it had a $28 million budget. Incredible zombie film. We're talking about fast zombies, all right? So if you guys want to get a nice spook on, this is it, man. Blood and guts and gore and drama, survivors, and their whole goal was to escape the mall and get to a boat at the marina down the road, and then sail off to an island. Will they make it? I don't know. I do know, because I watched it. You should watch it. Let's move on to number one. Okay, so coming in at number one is the zombie classic Night of the Living Dead, the 1968 original film directed by George A. Romero. This thing was a classic. It was insane. It was black and white, very gritty, and very realistic. Not a lot of, like, explosions and obviously no CG backgrounds or anything crazy like that. This was real and gritty. It was a $114,000 budget. But it grossed $18 million back in 1968. That's insane. That's a lot of money for that time. And it also was the basis of five more Living Dead films created by George A. Romero. So this is where he got his start at. This thing was a huge success. It was originally criticized heavily because at the time, this was considered like explicit content and never been done before. But eventually it gained like critical acclaim and has since been selected by the Library of Congress for preservation in the National Film Registry, which is a big deal. So this is like literally the definition of a classic film right here. You should watch it if you haven't. I didn't think I was gonna enjoy it the first time I watched it, but I did, because it's more likely that if there was a zombie apocalypse to take place, it would be a lot like this film right here. You should really give it a chance. I think you'll enjoy it, but it surrounds the story surrounds a few characters that are trapped in a farm type atmosphere, just kind of out in the middle of nowhere in Pennsylvania, surrounded by the undead. And this is the cool part. So when this movie came out, there was no such thing as zombies. Like, people didn't know what to call these things that they were watching on the film. It was later kind of like a pop culture thing that named these zombies. So this was like the first of its kind in this film right here. So you should really, if you haven't gotten a chance to watch it, go watch it. I mean, it's totally worth it. You can always say you've watched a classic film. So that's my top five, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this. You know, and so if you think that I left one out, You know, leave it down below in the comment section if you think my list was in the wrong order. Please give me your own order. I'll read it. We'll discuss. And life is fragile, guys. I'd like to take this time for a quick second, if I may, to say that life is fragile. You don't ever know when it's going to be taken from you. And so while you have the chance, you should tell people just how you feel about them before it's too late. So I would like to publicly right now say to Jimmy, you know, thank you very much for what you've done for me this year. And I really appreciate it. You've been a really good mentor to me on YouTube and a good friend. And I wish nothing but the best for you and your family. And thank you for taking me on this journey with you. I really appreciate it. And we got Extinction coming out, guys. So you're going to be stuck with me for another year. It's been your boy, Lackin24. And I will see you next time.